Several weeks ago, we posted a teardown video of the Cooktag No. 30 power bank. You can click the upper corner to check it. And today we got another power bank from Cooktag, the No. 20 power bank. It looks like the Anker 140 watts PD 3.1 power bank we talked about before. Let's go ahead and take apart this power bank to see what it looks like inside. The transparent packaging is unique, and it belongs to the P-series, modulus P23. Flip to the back, all specs info are on the back. Take it out from the top of the box. Except for the power bank, it also comes with a dual USB-C cable and a user manual. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it supports up to 240 watts and USB 2.0. And the length of this cable is about 50 cm. There is a display on the front with a power button below it. Press the button, the screen will light up to indicate the charging status. Since the maximum energy does not exceed 100 watts hour, you can put it into your backpack or handbag and board the plane. And those strips on the side and top can make the power bank more stable. There are two USB-C and a USB-A ports on the upper panel, which means you can charge three devices at the same time. The size of this power bank is about 160 by 54.5 by 54.5 mm, and the weight is about 634 grams. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C one supports PD 3.1, PPS, QC5, DCP protocols. It also has 6 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 28V, 5A, and 2 sets of PPS. As for the USB-C 2, it only supports PD 3.0, PPS, QC4, DCP protocols. It also has 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 2.25A, and 2 sets of PPS. Finally, the USB-A supports FCP, AFC, QC 3.0, DCP protocols. The first step is to remove 2 screws on the side and remove the top and bottom covers. Now we can see the internal PCB. Continue to remove the remaining screws. The entire module can be easily taken out. After removing the transparent plate, we can see the flat cable and the display. The micro switch is soldered on the flat cable. The first PCB is on the upper layer. The lower PCB is larger than the first one. There is aluminum alloy plate between them for heat dissipation. A battery cell is in the upper left corner. Two nickel strips are connected to PCB by solder joints. Here is the connector of the acquisition wires of battery cells. The other 4 battery cells are under the main PCB. Some thermistors are placed between different battery cells. Those 5 21700 battery cells are connected in series from EVE. Rated capacity is 5000 mAh. Then let's check the first PCB, which is used for the output of USB-C 2. It's connected to the larger PCB by those pins. The MCU is from WCH, which is an industrial-grade enhanced MCU based on 32-bit RISC-V instruction set and architecture. The buck bus controller of USB-C 2 is from Southchip, which is used to buck boost the input DC voltage. There are four synchronous buck boost MOSFETs around the 2.2 microhenry alloy inductor. They are from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30 volts, 2.75 milliohm for each. And those white silicon adhesives can enhance heat dissipation. This is a discharge resistor. The solar capacitor for upper filtering is from Capaxon, 100 microfarad, 25 volts. Two VBUS MOSFETs are used for USB-C to output. Those 8 mLCC capacitors are connected in parallel for filtering. The connector of the display is pasted with yellow heat resistant tape. Here is the buck circuit that powers the controller and MCU. Then let's move on to the larger PCB, which is used for the output of USB-C 1 and USB-A. The tin copper are exposed on the front and back of the PCB to enhance heat dissipation. The buck boost controller for USB-C 1 140W is also from SouthChip, same as the USB-C 2. Like the USB-C 2, four synchronous buck boost MOSFETs are around the alloy inductor. They were all from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 40 volts, 5 milliohm. Two solid capacitors for upper filtering are connected in parallel, 35 volts, 100 microfarad. Two upper VBUS MOSFET of USB-C 1 are connected in series, marked with AP1. As for the USB-A, the buck boost controller is also from SouthChip, but in a different model. The buck boost alloy inductor for USB-A is smaller than that of two USB-C boards. The upper VBUS MOSFET of USB-A is next to the USB-A connector, and the USB-A connector is pasted with heat-resistant tape. The protocol chip is actually an MCU with an 8051 core from ABOV. It supports PD3.1 and a wide range of fast charging protocols. The battery protection chip is from ICM, which is also seen on other power banks. It integrates high-precision voltage current detection circuits and can protect the battery cells. Those two battery protection MOSFETs are from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30 volts, 1.4 milliohm. Two 5 milliohm resistors are connected in parallel for current detection of battery pack. Well, that's all components of the Cooktec No. 20 PD3.1 power bank. It's equipped with three Apple ports and has a large capacity of 25,000 mAh. The USB-C 1 supports PD3.1 and can provide up to 140 watts upper power, which is very rare in the market. After taking it apart, we found it integrates 5 battery cells and 2 PCBs are stacked together to make the power bank smaller. You can also check the real-time charging status through the color display on the front at a glance. Okay, that's all for today's video. Feel free to click the link in the description if you want to support them on Indiegogo. See you in the next video. Bye!